Today, we're going to be exploring the D5 rendering software. Now, I'm going to be showing you some of the new updates, how you can drastically improve scenes, how to generate animations, and most importantly, to my Revit audience, I'm going to be showing you how to set up a live link from Revit to the D5 render. Let's go. With the new updates, we now have the GI or Global Illumination solution for D5 render, and this gives us kind of a superior corona level lighting in a real-time manner. For example, this scene only uses two lights to achieve this lighting effect. Now, to get the D5 render for free, I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. And also, if you want a complete kind of in-depth tutorial of a Revit D5 workflow, which I have created in the past, I'm going to be linking that up in the cards above as well, so you can check it out. And full disclosure, this is a sponsored video. Now, first, before we jump into the D5 render, I would like to take a look at the new trailer just to see what we can expect. So let's take a look. So here they've got this. Okay, this scene looks really good. And I'm guessing they're showing us some light adjustments and just how everything changes in real time. Okay, this looks really impressive. Yeah, that really shows us like what kind of this global illumination, what can it achieve for renderings. Okay, this looks really good. So I don't want to spoil it for myself anymore. So now without any further ado, let's jump into D5 render. And here we are in D5 render. I have this beautiful scene, which I've downloaded from the D5 render website. And now I just want to show you kind of what I consider the most powerful part of the D5 render, and that's going to be the assets. So if we open up the assets here, what you'll notice is that we have a very large library. Let's make it a bit smaller. Okay, where we have different types of assets. So by default, it's going to show us the materials first. So here we can see that these are materials. And then if you want to change material of anything, you can simply click on the material. It's going to download that material and then you can apply it to wherever you want. So here, for example, if I want to apply this floor material or this concrete material to the floor, I can just click on it and then I can just place it there and it's going to apply that material. So it's really easy to make drastic changes in your scene with this just by changing the materials. And then of course the library is really vast. Now if you go here in the inspector here, you can see we have the mapping for these materials, and then here we can make some adjustments so you're not kind of limited to the original setup of the materials. You can adjust them further if you want. Okay, moving forward, apart from the materials, we can actually add some interesting elements. So for example, here, let's search for models, and then I'm going to go with nature. And then here we can just find something that we can fit. So for example, here, let's look for some shrubs. And then let's see something that would work with this scene here. So for example, I can say, okay, I want to add something like, let's add something like this. So I can just click on it. It's going to download that element. And now I can click on that element and I can place it wherever I want. So for example, here, it's going to recognize the surface. So it's going to position it properly on that surface. So I can just come in here and place this little shrub. Now, of course, you're not only limited to shrubs. I can add animals, people. So for example, if I go here to characters, I can find, let's go with casual, and then let's find a casual character to add here. So for example, we have this casual man taking a photo. I like that, so let's place him here so he can take a photo of that little tree that we, or a little shrub which we have added. And then of course, he's not alone. Of course, he is with his animal. So let's just minimize this menu, go to animals, and then let's find pets. And then let's see if we can find him a pet. This one looks dangerous, so let's go with something like, okay, let's add this puppy here. And again, it's going to just download that element, and then we can click and we can place the puppy next to the guy taking a photo, so now he's no longer alone. So there you go, that's basically how you can add elements to your scenes. So as you can see, they're also animated, so the dog, you can see it's kind of looking around, wagging his tail. I think it's really cool to have that animation, and you can also see in the nature it's kind of moving as it usually would with the wind and everything. So a lot of these elements are indeed animated. Okay, so moving forward, let's take a look at some of the environment settings. So we have a couple of options. One is HDRI, and then we have the Geo and Sky. So the Geo and Sky will give you this little slider where you can actually adjust the position of the sun or what time of day is it. I think it's really cool. It can adjust it kind of properly, especially when we have a scene like this where lighting is really important and it makes a huge difference. I think this is a really nice option. And then we can also do a north offset. So for example, if you want to change, so for example, let's make it like so they're actually in the sunlight. And then of course you would try to adjust this to the kind of correct orientation of the project. Now we have some options in terms of the weather. So if I look up, you can see some clouds there, and then I can play around with the amount of clouds, with the thickness of clouds, the density, height, and actually the speed as well. So if you want some fast moving clouds, there we go. And then finally we can actually change the direction. So as you can see, those clouds are now kind of changing directions, zigzagging as they move this around. So that's another option that we have. Then we have the fog. Now in this scene, probably don't want to see that much fog, but yeah, it's possible. See here how we can see the mountains or the nature outside. If I increase the fog, it's going to, well, fog it up. Okay, so I'm just going to decrease that. And then also we have the wind, so I can turn on the wind, and then we can have kind of a strength, high strength wind. Now here we're kind of in an interior scene, so it doesn't make too much of a difference. What I like more than all of these settings is the precipitation. So as you can see, we can turn on rain, and then we can actually go and set it to even snow. So we can have either snow here, or we can have rain. So we can kind of adjust that to whatever we like. We can adjust the strength as well. We can adjust the puddles. So is it kind of forming puddles on the ground? Especially if we turn this to snow, then it's kind of, as you can see, we actually have snow here in the middle, which is kind of cool. So anyways, I'm just going to reduce all of this, reduce the strength, and then finally just turn the whole thing off. Now also you have the HDRI. So what this basically is, it's like adding like a dome, and then it would basically have lighting according to the image that's plastered on that dome. So you can go here and you can actually exchange those domes. So here we have a kind of a midday scene, we have a partly cloudy one, HDRI, which we can use. We can use the evening glow one, which kind of looks interesting, and so on and so forth. So you can kind of play around with these. In this case, let's see, early morning. Yeah, I like the early morning one. And then here below, we can adjust the color temperature. So you want to have it warmer, colder, you can do that. For the sun, the sunlight intensity, and so on, you can adjust that. And some additional. So again, we do have the fog and the wind and all of those. So that's kind of the same as we had previously with the Geo and Sky. Okay, so now I want to show you something really interesting and fun, and that's the fact that you can actually animate scenes in the D5 render. So for example, for this nice scene, let's say I want to add some sort of an animation. What I can do is I can just go here to this video mode, and it's going to give me kind of a set of cameras down here. So we have this camera, we have this camera, so it already has some cameras. Now I'm actually going to get rid of the second scene, and then I'm going to create a new one. So let me just kind of orbit around here, perhaps come to our person taking a photo, so we can go like that. Perhaps here, add a camera, and then something like this, a little bit from above, so we can see him and the dog. add that camera, and then we can zoom all the way out and just show where he's standing and how just how big this thing is. And then we can add, I'm just going to add two so I can have some time in the middle. And then let's reduce this time a little bit, so like that. And now we can play our animation. So it's just going to kind of animate around. We can see that little plant which we have added. The guy's taking a photo of that. And then we're kind of zooming out and just realizing how large this whole thing is and understanding the kind of the scale of it. So we have actually created now a quick little animation with just a few clicks and adjustments of our camera. So now I'm going to stop that and I'm going to add one more clip. So here, what I want to do with this one is I'm just going to go down and perhaps let's come to the same position here where we were. And then let's actually take a look at this tree because it's so nice. Something like that. And then I'm going to create an animation which is going to show us what this place looks like depending on the weather and the time of year. So I'm just going to create one camera, then I'm going to create another camera, and I'm going to go to the environment settings. And here I'm going to let's go and open up the precipitation, and here we're going to have rain. We're going to have a lot of rain and some puddles forming. So that's going to be the second one. Then the third one, I'm going to actually turn that rain into snow. And then for the next one, I'm going to get rid of the rain altogether. And then for the final one, we can even go with something a bit brighter, like let's go with the midday. Okay, so now we can test what this looks like. So I'm just going to hit play and let's make it just a bit shorter. So something like, yeah, so it's just a bit quicker. And let's hit play. So it's first kind of regular weather, and then slowly it's going to start raining. There we go. And then that rain turns into snow. And then finally, the snow is going to stop. So there we go. We have just a quick animation of going through different kind of ambience depending on the weather and the time of year. Now let's show how Revit is integrated with the D5 render via Live Sync. So here I am at the D5 converters page. I'm just going to link that up in the cards above so you can check it out and download it for yourself. So here I'm going to scroll down and find the Revit. As you can see here, it's going to support everything from Revit 2018 up to Revit 2024. So I'm just going to download that and then install it. Now here you can select do you want it installed for all versions of Revit or just for some. So in this case, for example, let's say I only wanted to use it with Revit 2021. I can simply only select Revit 2021 and then only install it for that version of Revit. So the first time now when I open up Revit, it's going to give you this pop-up warning about the D5 add-in. You just want to click on Always Load, and then it's going to load in that as a plugin inside of Revit. Now I have opened up this office building project that they have, and what you'll notice now is because we have installed the plugin here, it's going to say D5 render. Now before we start the D5 render, I'm going to open up settings here, and I just want to show you something that you might want to set up. So first is the use survey point. I think this is really useful to turn on because when you're using linked files, D5 render is going to allow you to load in all of those links, but it does need to use those survey points in order to make sure that the model is set up correctly and everything is going to be in its right position. Now, also here we have the use consistent colors. This is also really useful because it is going to copy the consistent colors object style here from Revit, and then you can apply materials later on in D5. Now, this is going to be perfect because you usually don't want to use all of the Revit materials that you have. You want to use the superior D5 render materials, so it makes sense to have kind of very basic materials on the model when it's loaded in the D5. Next, here we have the option for export smoothness. Now, this is something that you only want to crank up in cases where you have something that really requires high smoothness. So, for example, when you're working with some curved buildings, this might make sense, but even in those cases, it might make a lot more sense to separate those kind of smooth elements and then export those at high smoothness, but then export the rest of the model at something like 8 or similar. So this will kind of prevent having too heavy of files in D5. And then here you can select the categories to be separated if you want. I don't, so I'm just going to click here on save. Now to start the D5 render, you can do it straight from Revit from this plugin. So you just go here to start D5 and it's going to open up the D5 render. And here we have our model in D5. And as you can see, we have those consistent colors applied. So now we can start applying materials as I have shown you a bit earlier in this video. Now, if we go back to Revit, what you'll notice is here we have some options for syncing cameras and lights. So for example, if you already have cameras set up and I have some 3D views set up here, well, I can just sync those cameras. So what that will do is if I open up the D5 render here, you'll notice it's going to set up all of those as scenes, so I can continue using them and I can just kind of have them set up in Revit and then I can use them in D5 later on, which is going to save me time from having to do the work, well, twice. And that's the workflow for using D5 render in combination with Revit, which is what I'm guessing that most of you are interested in. So again, as I said, if you want to check out D5 render, I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description and also up in the cards above, you can get it for free. And I'll be back with another Balkan Arctic tutorial in a couple of days. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.